getting ready.
We're getting ready.
Today is the day.
This is the moment that you've been waiting for. If you're struggling with your videos and you want to start generating leads, you're in the right place.
Sweet.
I have a very special co-host and guest today, and that is Mr. Greg Martin, a top-tier real estate agent here in San Diego, already using live video effectively. I want to say welcome and thank you.
Thanks for having me in.
Yeah.
Happy to be here.
Awesome. So now, one of the questions I said to Greg when we were getting started was, what's your biggest struggle right now with Facebook Live? And what did you say?
I think was just driving as much engagement as possible and actually also getting people to actually show up in person from my Facebook Live posts.
Yeah, get somebody to show up on the Facebook Live and then show up actually at the open house, right?
Yeah,
that's
exactly.
The name of the game.
Exactly.
All right. So then I started asking some really interesting, thought-provoking questions, if I may. And that was, what is the purpose of it? But how does that work? And you gave answers like, well, it increases my top of mind awareness. It gets people to see my brand, right?
Yep, exactly.
And I kept pressing. I said, but how? And you said, well, when somebody shares my video, for example, that's something that's going to drive awareness, right?
Yep. And comments on it and gives that heart symbol, all that good stuff.
Yeah. Yes, exactly. So the name of the game is to, drum roll please, get comments. You have to get comments to get seen. So if you're looking to lower your cost of marketing, increase your reach, drive engagement, get in front of new people and the people who know, like, and trust you, it doesn't matter. You have to get comments.
Yeah.
But before you can get comments, you got to get them to come into your video. You got to get them to click on it. You got to get them to pay attention. You got to stand out, right?
Yep, exactly.
Because the purpose of Facebook is to get engagement. That's what drives the light leads. That's what drives people coming to your open houses. But you have to focus on getting comments between the people who are what? Watching in replay and
people who are watching live.
And the people who are watching live. Hey, Saeed, thank you so much for your comment. Thank you so much. So, so if you're actually trying to get people in replay to watch your video, commenting back on every single comment will not work. It'll drive people crazy, right? Especially when we're getting a ton of comments. But you need to be able to engage with people who are in fact engaging with you, so they'll keep commenting because we just said it, the name of the game is in fact to get comments, right? So there's a little bit of a balancing act here. So I have a checklist here available to you. Hey, Conrad, you just comment below and we will send it right over so you can follow along with the top 10 ways to be able to integrate your intros to get leads on live. All right, but I have some best practices even beyond, above and beyond that, right?
Mm-hmm.
We talked a little bit about this. So first of all, how long do you have when somebody's scrolling to get them to engage with your video?
A few seconds, probably.
Yeah, you got 3 seconds.
Yep.
3 seconds, that's it. Right, Conrad? How many seconds do you have and what do you do to get people to engage? Comment below. So the first thing you can do is you can smile and look into the camera as much as possible, right? So even as we're interviewing here and I'll ask you a question and we're humans, we're looking at each other, you'll notice that I'll come back to the camera to coach you as the guest to also look at the camera, right?
Mm-hmm.
Because big smiling faces are what's going to get people to engage. Now, this is my serious face. Sometimes I gotta get real serious and go over the top and get people to comment. Look, that's my husband. That's Scott Lindsay.
That's my Scott.
You know my serious face, right? All right, Conrad says, I think that's what I'm struggling with is define a pattern interrupt. So good, right? Because people are stuck in their patterns. They're scrolling on that highway of social.
I know a good one for you.
Yes, give it to him. Give it. Yes, is that it? We're going to point?
Yeah.
That's a good one.
Yeah, we're getting close to the camera.
Look at that.
Just like it says.
Oh my goodness, yes, indeed. So, absolutely. So what you want to do is be able to find that pattern interrupt. And yes, Saeed, you have maybe 10 seconds. Generally, the attention span right now we're struggling with as humans, as marketers, as real estate.
8 minutes? Is that what you had said?
8 seconds.
Oh, 8 seconds.
Yeah,
I got it way wrong. Eight seconds.
8 seconds. We're approaching the jellyfish. Okay, maybe it's the goldfish. But still, if you're struggling to get seen and you only have 8 seconds, on social, it's even faster than that. They're not even going to give you that full 8 seconds. So you got to do a pattern interrupt. I love that, Conrad. I'm going to use that. So this is a pattern interrupt. I like that. You got to get serious. But again, smiling faces actually outperform the serious, overly emotional. But I like getting in the camera. Yeah. Notice what he did, though. He created movement. He got close. He got serious. He got out of his comfort zone. He laughed afterwards. All of those things are going to engage people into your video. Now, you'll notice I have my little prop here. Just so you know, we're using this one. This one is not plugged in. This is totally a prop. I just want to get in there and act like this. You also can have a little mic that's not attached and just use it as a little prop if that's what you need to be able to get started. You also want to thank people who are watching in replay, right? Who's watching when you first log on, you first go live and it counts you in? Who's watching that?
Anybody that's actively on the app at the moment that you go live, right?
Exactly. Okay. And how many people are actively on the app in those first couple seconds?
Not that many.
Right? It's abysmal. So 99% of the people in those first couple seconds are going to be watching in replay. So just engage them and just say, hey, if you're watching a replay, I've got something special for you. So stay with me. And you know you're going to engage with viewers, like with Conrad and Saeed, and giving them shout outs. Then maybe you can tell them, I want you to go ahead and skip ahead a minute or two if you know that you're going to do that as a buffer, right?
Sure. Yeah,
a lot of people will come on and they'll have their app open and they'll be commenting. And it is a best practice to go live a few minutes before your scheduled time so that you can, if you have a scheduled time, you actually make it.
Yeah.
So that people aren't actually giving up on you and going away, right?
That's true.
So you got to go on a little bit early, and that part drives me crazy because I'm not talking and I just sit there and it's nerve wracking, right? But it's part of the process.
Yeah.
So do something where you show up, have your iPad if you're going to scroll, have a quick prompt if you want to lean in, whatever it is, and engage with your viewers. But know that most of your views are coming in replay. So if the comments are not deepening your engagement, the topic matter at hand, right? If it's derailing you, if it's setting you back, if you have to repeat yourself something you already said, then just move on.
Yeah.
Right? But so there's a balance, right? Yeah. You got to know when to respond and when not to. Now, I also encourage you to give thanks by name, right? You'll mm-hmm. notice just now, I was just gave a shout out to Conrad, to Saeed. I said hi to Scott. So you can call out by name, and that really does encourage more comments. And the name of Facebook Live is to get
comments. Yeah.
So you want to be able to encourage that. And you want to give a call to action to share this video. So this is my call to action. If you're struggling with live video, so are your friends. Share this video so they can get these tips, all right? So you want to get people involved and engaged. And there's a really easy way to be able to do that. There's one word. Thank you, Jason. There's one word that you need to say to be able to increase your viewership by 97%. But I'm not giving it to them yet. Oh. You got to stay tuned because I'm going to give you that by the end of the broadcast. That's my tip number 10. Did I say that? Am I holding it ransom?
You are.
If you comment enough, I'll give it to you early. How about that? No. Seriously, this is the number one tip you need to do to be able to get seen, is you got to use this word. So you're in the right place if you're finding yourself using live video, but you're not getting as many comments or engagements as you would like. If you want to get leads, you have to get comments. And in order to get comments, you got to have people click on your video. So you need to focus on using those first 3 seconds to be able to engage your viewers and start generating leads. So if you're watching a replay, I want to say thank you so much. And look, Conrad's thinking about this. He says, you got me. What's that word? Comment below with what you think it is. All right. So again, I'm Crystal Lindsay, social media entrepreneur, strategist, and college professor. Yes. And I want to teach you how to be able to use live video to generate leads. I'm creating a community of entrepreneurs and real estate agents who are on fire to get seen on social media. And each week I'm delivering top tips in my live video mastery seminars so you can take action today. Stop making excuses and start taking action, because when you know what to do, it's easy.
That's right.
And when you don't know what to do, what does it feel like?
It's very confusing and hard.
It's very confusing and hard, right? So now, Greg, how did you first get started? When you first started using live video, what inspired you to be able to take action?
A slightly reckless personality in a sense. Just wanted to get out there and try it. So I just started doing it.
Okay.
And I definitely fumbled and failed my way at the very beginning.
Right.
Made some bad videos, but in time you learn. But yeah.
Yes. And so how has live videos helped your business?
I have several clients who have found me on Facebook.
Wow.
And I'm working with them now to help find houses.
Yes.
But mostly it has increased my brand awareness.
Yes.
Everybody now knows that I am a real estate agent.
Yes.
So that's been the biggest help.
Absolutely. Yeah. And one of the hacks that we want to share with you here is that you decided to use your personal profile.
Correct.
Instead of your business page.
Yes.
So real estate agents, entrepreneurs, start thinking about, should you use your personal profile or your business page? Now, just getting started, you want people to like and comment, and the people who know, like, and trust you are the ones who are most likely to like and comment, right?
Correct.
So what was your experience when you first went live on your personal profile? Did you already have a ton of people showing up? Did you get a couple
No.
comments? What happened?
Nothing happened.
Nothing?
Like the first several videos, maybe a couple of likes here and there, but no comments. It wasn't much, mostly because I didn't know what I was doing. So yeah, that was my experience.
And you didn't have the secret word.
I did not have the secret word.
He did not have the secret word. He got the secret word today, right before we got started. Because he came down for the hands-on workshop here in Emerald Plaza.
Mm-hmm.
So if you're an entrepreneur, real estate agent in San Diego, I recommend that you comment below and I will get you complimentary tickets for your very first live video mastery workshop so you can get the scoop and start taking action. That's how we got our worksheet. May I show yours? Look,
absolutely.
We've got lots of notes going on all around here, right? So this is your chance to be able to take action. We do this in person and we start at 2:30 every Thursday. So this week again is 10 ways to capture leads by investing in the first 3 seconds. Last week was how to look good on camera, lighting, budget, and audio. If you missed that, make sure you get the link. I'll get you that. And Conrad, I'd love to see you down here. This would be fun. And then the next week is how to easily speak like your client. Mm-hmm. Speak like your client. Why does that matter? Because if you care about what they care about, they're more likely to engage.
Absolutely.
Right? If you're talking about really high-level stuff that's really important to you in your industry as a level 10 expert, they're never going to engage. You have to bring it down to the questions you had when you first got in this industry. So that's next week. Because again, live video, social media right now is all about effective and meaningful storytelling.
Yep.
Video storytelling, right? So I see a special shout out to Clayton Connolly. He has been rocking it, another real estate agent in San Diego using live videos.
Nice.
So a special shout out. He's been learning all of my tools on storytelling branding.
Nice.
So we've already talked about the first 3 seconds are the most important.
Yes.
Right?
Correct.
Why? Why are the first 3 seconds most important?
Because that's all the time you got until the next person just scrolls right past your post.
Yep. They're going to keep on cruising. You got to capture them, reel them in. And what I'm teaching you to do is go live with style. Right, Clayton? I know you got some style. He always got that top hat. Have you seen Clayton Connolly in his top hats?
I don't think I have.
Oh, we're talking like full top hat. This man's
like
got style.
Meet this guy.
Yes. I think you two should meet. We got to get you both down here for the same broadcast. This will be fun. I see you giving us some love. Thank you so much. So again, today we're talking about how to go live with style because nobody, and that's nobody, likes a talking head. Oh wait, did I say that really seriously? But I meant it, right? Because what happens when you sit there and you see somebody sitting at their desk and they say, I've got some live video tips for you today. I would like for you to click on this video. How would you react to me?
Next.
So you gotta do something because nobody likes a talking head. All right. So what can you do as a real estate agent? And we spent some time talking with Greg about how he's using live video at open houses.
Mm-hmm.
And my question to you is, what are some things you can do to create visual interest or movement to get people to engage with your video?
One of the things I really liked that you had said was using props.
Mm-hmm.
was a really good way, just like your microphone that you use. I guess as a realtor I could use, we were coming up with some good ideas like a flyer or a listing sign. Or me.
Yes,
Just leaning more into the camera. Those are some great ways that you would
Yes.
Come up with.
So this is great. Okay, first of all, he said there's a prop, like an actual physical thing you would think of, like a prop.
Yeah.
The second thing would be there's a sign. You can use like a listing sign or a brochure for the listing.
A flyer, yeah.
A flyer, yeah. Exactly. Yeah. And then the third thing is, let's say you don't have any of that and you just got yourself. Guess what? If you're about to get started, lean in and lean out. You're your own prop. Look, you lean in, you lean out. This is how it goes. Look, you're more engaged with the video already. You may think I'm crazy also, but you're more engaged because I'm giving you something to look at. So again, that is how you're going to be able to engage. And that's why it's important. Should we give them the top 10 tips?
I feel like we should.
I've been building it up. So let's see. We've got enough people on now. We're going to give you the top 10. But I just want to say, Conrad says, is the word authenticity? Close.
That's more descriptive.
But yeah, but you, how would you, isn't, I like where you're going with this. I do. But I'm going to give you this word. We're like a couple of moments away. So don't leave the broadcast. I'm literally going to give it to you right now. Okay. So, and Conrad, if you comment below just the word worksheet, then we'll go ahead and send you the link and you can have a sneak peek because I know you want it right now. Okay. So with that, 10 ways to capture your viewers to get started. The first thing I want to say is this is based primarily on a study done by Google. Google, if you didn't know, I know you know, but if you didn't know, Google bought YouTube, okay? YouTube is the biggest provider of video. They're the second biggest search engine. Google's number one, YouTube's number two. YouTube's all video, clearly the biggest video provider, okay? So this is based on video ads and videos on YouTube, all right? But I've translated it to live video. So I put in quotes here, the number one way, and this was according to their article, their number one way to be able to get seen is by what?
Being humorous.
Humorous and smiling characters. So I think that's funny because smiling characters is not exactly how I would describe people.
I thought it was emojis at first when you said smiling characters.
Be humorous and have smiling characters. Emojis, yeah. Maybe if you have a emoji on a popsicle stick. That, oh my gosh, I got to print out my... Oh man, my props just got expanded. I'm getting them laminated. Oh my goodness. Okay, watch out. Stay tuned. You saw it right here off the crystal mind. Okay, so then I'm going to have a prop with a smiling character, which is a smiling emoji, and myself, right?
Yeah.
But that's the number one way. Now, they did say that humor outperforms emotion. So the example I gave in our workshop right before this was that when you come on and you say, all right, you guys, I got live video, people are more likely to engage with that than, all right, you guys, I've got some live video, right? Are you ready for this? Are you ready? Right? Again, even in those moments, people are like tuning out because the drama and the melodrama, it has its time and place, but it's not your intro. So be humorous.
Yeah.
Tip number two, we've said 1,000 times today, is what?
Number two was to use a prop.
A prop. And we said a prop can be a physical object, it can be a sign, and it can be yourself if you lean in and lean out. All right? Yes. Oh. Conrad commented, lean in and lean out, right? Lean in, lean out, lean in. All right, I'm not going to do it again. Okay, now you're going to create movement. So that's tip number three. So I've already given you that rolled up into tip number two. But even if you don't have a prop, do something to create movement.
Yeah.
What's something you can do at an open house to create movement?
Well, if I'm walking around the property, I could probably just be showing the property, spinning around, whether I'm in the video or not.
Yeah.
I'm actively walking through the house, so that would be a good way.
Yes, exactly. So now, Greg has a gimbaled selfie stick. Okay, I should have got mine, so I have it here as a prop. But the idea is it holds your phone sideways while he walks and it moves with him, so it's fluid.
Okay,
it's a stabilizer. Yeah.
Exactly.
So I'll drop the link down below. Let me go ahead and make myself a note, and I'll send you the Osmo link. The Osmo is the granddaddy of live video, and it allows you to be able to walk around, and it has a panoramic effect. I know you put the wide angle lens on your phone.
Correct.
So that is another really great tip. The Osmo actually takes 9 photos every millisecond and stitches them together. So it's a wraparound effect and has built-in audio.
Wow.
It's incredible. It used to be $300 and now it's like $179.
Wow.
It's really quite incredible.
I want the link to that thing.
Yeah, so I'll get you the Osmo, okay? So the Osmo is a great way. And then you can just simply spin around and go all the way around. That creates movement. So even if you don't have a prop, You can lean in and lean out. Okay, that's the last time I'm doing it, you guys. And, or you can spin around. I know. Okay, I can't promise. So that is the idea, right? So you want to create movement. Okay, tip number four is a little bit outside the box, okay, but I put it on here because it's important. I'm giving a shout out to Edwin Victory, who wrote and recorded my 333 jingle. I should have it playing right now. So just imagine. They say it's the thought that counts, so just think about it. It's playing. So again, if you have a jingle or you have something that is funny or silly that represents your brand, bring it in. Now, Edwin Victory actually does full mascots. He got in a full mascot at SDAR and stood at my booth and recruited people over, okay? Nice. And he makes them for your company. So if you want a mascot for your company, I've got the hookup. If you want a jingle for your company, I've got the hookup, okay? This man is a creative dynamite performer and marketer. He's a multifaceted man. He was on the show last week. So special shout out, we'll go ahead and tag. I'm gonna make a note again for Mr. Edwin Victory because I gave you so much love. I gotta give you some love and let you know I did that. Now, tip number five is we're gonna introduce a problem and promise a solution. Mm-hmm. Now we're walking into that number one word, Conrad, okay? So that number one word, you have to connect with that person and tell them that you understand their needs by painting a picture. So you would say, hey, are you struggling with this thing? Well, great. I am going to be able to solve your problem with this. Or do you want this and you're struggling with this? You hear me say it every single week, right? Then great, I'm gonna be able to help. So again, these are not a 1 through 10, check the box, do all 10. I'm saying pick one, integrate into your next broadcast. Pick 3, 4 maybe. You don't need to do all of these. But picking a problem and promising a solution. What's one that, for a real estate agent, this seems a little abstract. Help us bring it down.
Probably when I'm working with first-time home buyers, yes, oftentimes they want to buy a house, but they're really struggling with the approval process. Yes. That's their biggest question is, what can I afford? What do I qualify for?
Yeah.
So
you would say, are you a first-time home buyer who wants to find your dream home but struggling with the application process?
Yeah.
Right?
Exactly.
And boom, now all of a sudden you've got people's attention. Right? So that's an example of how you can promise a solution to a problem. And then you just say, great, I'm going to be able to help you on today's broadcast, right? Just a little summary statement. The next thing you want to do is promise a story tied to their needs or interests. Now, again, this kind of builds upon that. I would say these two are kind of connected. So may I build upon your example here?
Sure.
So Greg says, hey, are you a first-time home buyer who wants to be able to get your dream home, but you're struggling with the application process? Great, you're in the right place. I'm Greg Martin, your top-tier real estate agent in San Diego, and I have 3 tips that I'm going to be able to give to you today. But first, let me tell you a story of a client that I worked with just like you to show you how this would work, right? So, and
I'm
then,
all ears.
Yeah, right?
Tell me more.
And now you're like, I wanna know. And then my favorite words are, so I worked with a client, for example, I worked with a client who, and then you finish with, and then when they met me, I was able to help them with these things,
yep,
right? So you say their struggles and all that. Again, you hear this from me every week. I'm not gonna go down all the rabbit holes. But again, do you want this thing? In this case, are you a first-time home buyer, wanna buy your house, but you're struggling with the application process and you don't know where to start and you're paralyzed? Great, let me talk to you a story about a client I worked with who wanted to buy their first home, was struggling with the application process. It was actually a young couple and she found out she was pregnant and all of these things. And now they want the best school district, but they're priced out of the neighborhood. They're getting outbid by all these places. This was with the last agent, not you, right?
Are you sure you're not a realtor? You
right?
know all the problems.
Right, it's true. So then, and then you say, but then when they met me.
Yep.
Right now the story shifts. You're not the hero, you're the guide.
Yeah.
But then when you met me, I was able to help them go to, you know, 3 different open houses, put in, you know, 3 different offers, and they were able to get their dream home within a matter of 2 weeks because they got pre-approved in that first week, right?
In the great school district.
In the great, and now you finish with how their life is better, and you say, and now they're living in this incredible neighborhood and they have access to this really great school system ranked number one. And they're going to be able to do all these cool things at the beach and walk around Coronado or whatever. Okay.
They're not paying rent anymore.
They're not paying rent. They're building an asset. They're so proud of themselves. They can host parties. You can go big even. It's helped their marriage. You know, he's a better father because of he has time in the backyard with his son. I mean, go big, right?
Yeah.
You know, he's got time for his grill now. He's got a man cave. save. I mean, really take time to build that up. But again, I digress. I go through this every week. Today's about intros. But regardless, promise a story that's tied to that. So you say, do you want this but have this problem? Great, let me tell you about a client who, right? So you take them through that. Then you could tell your audience what makes you unique. So in this case, you could say, I've got these three tips I'm going to give you today, and I've got a story to show you how it's going to work. But first, I want you to really understand that I too was a first-time home buyer, and I too went through this process, or I was born and raised in San Diego, or, you know, I love Coronado and man caves. I don't know, okay? But say what makes you unique. If you're a Jets fan, I don't think anybody in San Diego is, go for it, you know? But just figure out what makes you unique. It's going to polarize the video, and then the people who don't like the Jets are going to comment. The people who do like the Jets are going to comment. And we said the point of Facebook Live was?
Get comments.
So tell them what makes you unique, right? All right, the next thing you can do is offer a surprise at the end. I thought you had a really great example on this. Walk, in terms of the open house and getting some comments, and you have a contest of sorts. Tell them about that.
Yeah, oftentimes I'll do contests within my videos for people to comment with what they think the right price of the property is. Mm. Like, price is right, like, guess the right price, but don't go over.
What's the best price without going over? Right?
Yes, yes. Bob Barkering.
You need a microphone so you can really... Oh, that one with the wire, the tall one?
Yes.
You need one of those. Okay, keep going. Yeah, so you have a contest going on.
And then whoever, at the end, I go through all the comments, and whoever gets the closest without going over gets the gift card to a local restaurant, or you said movie tickets.
Yeah.
That's a great idea, too. So.
Yeah, and the best way to tie it to that neighborhood, right? Especially
exactly.
If the movie theater is a big part of that neighborhood.
Yes, or a local restaurant, or a brewery. I'll do those sometimes. Yeah.
So offer a surprise at the end and say, if you guess the price without going over, or person who comments the most, or, you know, people who respond back. You could have whatever classification and qualifications you want, and maybe you tell them what the surprise is, and maybe you don't, and you just say, that person has a very special surprise at the end of the broadcast. So again, have a sign, have a prop to reinforce it. That's going to go a lot farther. So that is a tip number 9, actually, is use a sign or text to reach your audience. So you want to make sure that you are, in fact, using something visual to do it. Now, today, shame on me, I did not invert the footage so they cannot read this. See, it reads backwards.
Oh, no.
There's one small step you have to do. So bear with me. You either have to print your signs backwards, and so right now they would look forwards, or you have to invert your screen. You just click on that magical wand right there in the corner, and then the wrench. And then it says horizontal flip. It's literally 3 clicks. I just forgot to do it. Shame on me.
Okay.
All right. So drum roll, though. That's the 9. Let's do the 10. The biggest impact, easiest fix is you. Wait. You?
You.
You. You is the answer, Conrad. You. So you just have to say you in the first 5 seconds of your video.
Who?
You.
You.
Yes, yes, yes. How many U's does it take to get your video live and engaged? 2. Well, technically, 1 actually increases viewership by 67%.
Okay.
So if you even just say, are you a first-time home buyer? Even that just like wins.
Okay.
So that is a win. If you follow it up with a second, Conrad's like, me?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes, you, Conrad. You,
Conrad. If you follow it up with a second you, it actually increases viewership from 67% to 97%. They're 97% more likely to continue watching your video.
Sounds like you need to do that.
Let me just say, essentially, it doubles your view count, okay? If you say you in the first 5 seconds. That's, again, according to a Google study done on YouTube videos. So the perfect formula on the back of this worksheet you can't read right now is you want to go ahead and create movement in the first. So we're going to come in with the big old smiling characters. Yes. And then you're going to play a jingle if you got one. Da, 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 da. And then you're going to pop and prop. Huh? Okay, it wasn't the last time I did it. And you're going to lean into the camera, and you're going to say what you have to say, and then you're going to lean back. Just that right there. If you get nothing else out of this, that is going to increase your views. But what you really want is them to continue watching. So if you want them to continue watching, according to that statistic, you need to be able to use the word you twice. So then you finish with, again, on the worksheets, on the second page, do you want, are you struggling with, and then great, I can help. Okay, that's what I'm going to walk you through. So And then I threw in the little surprise thing. So it says, do you want, I like your first time home buyers, right? Do you want to get your dream home? Are you a first time home buyer who is looking to get your dream home, but you're just struggling because you're getting outbid, overpriced, and now you're not getting the right neighborhoods or the right schools? Look, I can help. Because specifically, I've got these three steps that I'm going to take you through. Or I'm at this incredible open house and this may be your dream home or whatever it is, right? And then you could say it. And if you comment, you know, the number one person with the most comments or, you know, whatever your qualifications are is going to get the surprise at the end. Just that, it's going to get them to keep watching and keep their interest, right? And then the last thing is you can have some type of sign or prop and a comment below. I will have this as well on a popsicle stick, maybe. Maybe just emojis on a popsicle stick. Who knows? And you just say, comment below if you're struggling with da 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 da. Comment below and you hold up your sign again and again. I used to have these way back when. I had them all in a manila folder.
Oh, really?
And I had actually went through and printed sign entrepreneurs who were like really struggling at their desk and were really happy at their computer. Mm-hmm. And I just kept them in a manila folder.
Okay.
And then as I did my broadcast, I laid them out on the table. And then I would say, are you feeling like this?
Yeah.
Then I want you to comment below. Are you feeling like this, right? Do you want to feel like this? Then comment below. So again, you can do that however you want.
Cool.
But that is your simple formula. But you need to understand, you need to capture interest or you're going to lose out. You'll have less people who click on your video, less people who care about your brand, less top of mind awareness, and less leads. So you will lose out if you don't do something to stand out and stop being a talking head. So decide what you're going to do right now to create visual interest. Write it down. Get your worksheet. Do something, but we need to give it to them straight. We gave them so much information. I always tend to make things harder than they have to be because I want to give you all of this, what's in here. I just want to like, just give it to you on a platter for free on Facebook Live and do funny faces all day. That would be perfect. But I know I need to simplify it. So let's give them a simple summary, 1, 2, 3.
Okay.
What's the number one thing that somebody should do in getting started?
I think they should smile.
Yes. You need to come in.
Smiling. Characters.
Yeah, channel your smiling character, okay? If you're not a big smiley type of person, I had a client in a loan industry, very dry, okay? Very smart and wonderful, highly sophisticated, but his brand was not warm and fuzzy,
sure. Okay?
So if you're in that category, I need you to really channel your child's graduation or the birth of your daughter or like something, okay? And put the twinkle in your eye and get that smiling character on because that's what you need to get people to engage. And then tip number two,
I think that it involves something around movement.
Yes.
Creating movement.
Yes. Be bigger than the camera. Get in there. Flex those guns, huh? Huh?
I think that's a great idea.
Yeah. Yeah. You could do this. Okay. Do something to create movement. And leaning in and leaning out is the perfect way to make it feel like you have multiple camera angles. All right, so then the third thing you're going to do.
Got that point across.
Yes, hopefully everybody knows they lean in and lean out now, right? So then the third thing you're going to do is you're going to say what?
We're going to say, what's the word? It's not me.
It's not me. It's you.
You.
It's you.
You.
You. All of you. I need you to say what you know about your client's needs. Now, this may take a quick brainstorm, right? I get the question asked, do I need to script everything? And it's like, no. Facebook Live isn't about memorizing and scripting. But what it is about is really understanding how you're creating value. It's understanding what product or service you're promoting, so you actually get leads off of it. And then what client profile, you know, rich, wealthy, affluent homeowners or first-time home buyers, right? It depends, right?
Yeah.
Which client profile is going to be most likely to engage with that product? And then out of that client profile, what clients have you worked with that you want 10 more just like, not the ones you don't want, okay? And which one of those ones fits that client profile? And then what do they ask you about? What do they care about? So you gotta kind of ask yourself that before you get started. And once you drill down, you're like, okay, we're promoting, I want people to meet with me to have an appointment to discuss their home, right?
Yep.
And their home search.
Yep.
And then out of that, I want to go after people who are looking to be first-time home buyers. Okay, Sally was a really great first-time home buyer. I want 10 more dislike. Okay, what did Sally ask me? She asked about financing and, you know, how to get through the process. So now you know what you need to ask. You know what Sally wanted and she was struggling with. That's your intro.
Yep.
It's also your post. It's also your social media post associated with it. That's a whole nother thing. but it's the same format. Do you want this? Are you struggling with this? Great, here's how I'm gonna help. That's your post, yep. Okay? So that's your simple summary. Stop trying to do it all. You're on every single, all of these tips on every single video on your very first time. It's not realistic, right? So just pick something.
Yep.
Do something. And what would you say about just showing up? Like, what would you say to somebody who's ready to get started, but they don't know what they need to do? What's your advice?
Do it.
Just do it.
Just get on there, smile, and just do something.
Channel channel your happy face and not your duck lips. And now the reason why I say that is because duck lips are not authentic, okay? There are no photos of me on the internet with duck lips because this is how it looks, okay? Nobody likes duck lips. But just say that to yourself. Like, if you think you have to be all buttoned down and overly sophisticated, how can you show up authentically in that space? Maybe it's a photo of your family. Maybe it's a big, authentic smile. Whatever it is to get you to show up authentically. But remember, humor does outperform emotional. So if you're comfortable being silly, bring it. Especially in those 8 seconds.
And if you're not, here's an expert.
And if not, come on down to my workshops if you're in San Diego, and I'll teach you how to be silly on camera. All right, so next week, I want you guys to stay tuned. I'm doing this every single week. I'm in the middle of a 16-part series. Can you believe that?
I believe it.
I broke down all of the aspects that you need to know to be able to do live video, and this is part 5. So part 6 is coming up, and that is how to easily speak like your clients. So get ready. If you want to create content that converts, you want to resonate with your audience, you want to get leads, you need to be here next week, because taking action is easy. Taking action is easy.
Yeah.
When you know what to do. So make sure you're intentional, you have a plan, show up weekly, get your prop, and smile, and go live with confidence. And this, I want to say, is your chance to stop making excuses, start taking action, and go live often. Because I'm Crystal Lindsay with 333 Social Media, and I want to see you be able to get leads on social. And this, my friends, is Greg Martin, top-tier real estate agent in San Diego. And if you're a first-time home buyer in San Diego looking for some support and somebody to get you through the process with ease, I want you to reach out to Greg. How can they get a hold of you?
You could reach out to me via Facebook. That's a great way.
All right, Greg Martin, Realtor on Facebook. And that's one G at the beginning, one G at the end. G-R-E-G, Martin. All right, with that, I'll see you next week. Ciao, ciao.
Bye, everybody.